Hey everyone, today I'm going to show you on how to flash Linknode R4 with ESPEasy firmware. So what do we need to flash this Linknode R4? Of course you need the Linknode R4 and also you need the 5 volts power supply to power the Linknode R4. Please note that this doesn't come with the Linknode R4 when you buy this one, so you have to get this one separately. And then you need the UART or the USB to TTL converter. When you buy this one, it comes with a USB cable, but it depends on the design that you are buying. Some of the USB to TTL converter is or has a connector directly to the computer USB port. You also need these jumper cable wires to connect the header pin of Linknode R4 and the UART. Okay, let's have a look how it is connected, or let's take a look at the pinout. It's very easy. It's only 3 connections between the UART and the Linknode R4, and that is the TX or the transmit. It has to be connected to the receive on the UART and then connected to the transmit of the Linknode R4. The second one is the RX, or the receive from the Linknode R4, has to be connected to the TX or the transmit in the UART. And the third one and the last one is the ground, has to be connected to the ground from the UART to the Linknode R4. The next one is that these 3 pins here, which is labeled as ground 0100 binary codes or the program in the 3.3 volts. When you are flashing the Linknode R4, this jumpering pin has to be jumpered to the program, the one in the middle, to the ground. That is when you're flashing the Linknode R4. And then once you finish the flashing, you need to remove this jumpering here and jumper to the middle and the 3.3 volts. So basically, this one here is to program. This one here is to boot from the flash. Another thing that you need to take note is when you are flashing the Linknode R4, make sure that the UART is in 3.3 volts. Most of the UART has a slider to select between 5 volts and 3.3. Make sure it's in 3.3. The next one that you need to take note also is that the model of the ESP8266 module, because you need to determine or to identify which binary file that you are going to use to flash the Linknode R4. I will going to show you later on how to identify which binary file you are going to select. Okay, so let's open a browser and search for ESPEasy. And on the top, which says letscontrolit.com, click that one. And from there, go to the tutorials, this one here, and select the using the flash tool to upload the ESPEasy firmware. Right click on the one and then open link in new tab. And once it's open on this page, you can identify which binary file that you require. Is it the 512K modules, 1024K modules, or the 4096K modules? So let's open our board or the Linknode R4. So if you look at in here, as you can see, this one here, 4096K module, the ESP-12E modules is the same as the one that we have, the Linknode R4. So it means that we need the 4096K or the 4 meg bin file. This will be our guide in selecting binary file that we need to flash to this Linknode R4. It's very identical because of this antenna here. And if you look at the other module, it's totally different. And also in the vendor's site, when you are buying this one, there should be a description where it is telling you that it's ESP-12 something. I think it was F from my memory. So after that, go back to the main page and then go to the loading firmware. In here, there are some old release, but we want the new release. So once you are in here, you just right click this link here and open link in new tab, and it will redirect you to the GitHub portal, which is showing you the latest ESPEasy binary files. Scroll down to the bottom, this one here, and you have files that you can download. And the only files that you need is ESPEasy binaries, download that one, and the ESPEasy underscore dist dot zip. You can also download the ESPEasy underscore docs, which will provide you the documentations and some tutorials like the rules in the supported hardwares and other things. So once you download that one, which I already did, let's go back here. It will look like this. This one here, the binary, ESP binaries, ESP dist. You have to right click on this one and then extract all. And once you finish extracting it, it will become a folder like this. Alright, so you open this one, ESP binaries, build output, and the bin. These are the binary files that I'm talking about before, that there's a lot of items in there. So that's why you need to identify which one, which bin file that you're going to use to flash your Linknode R4. So we already identified that it's a 4K or 4 meg. All you have to do is find the 4 meg. From the top here, it says custom, we don't want that. It's up to you if you want to use it. But in this tutorial, I'm going to use the normal, and I'm going to find the ESP8266. Normal ESP8266, but 4 meg. This one here. So you get 1 meg and the 4 meg. This is 4096K. So select this one and then right click, copy, and go to the ESPEasy underscore dist, the one that you downloaded as well. Open it and then go to the bin folder and then paste in here. Now let's flash the Linknode R4. Okay guys, so let's take a look at our Linknode R4. As you can see, it's jumpered in program mode and it's turned off at the moment, and it is connected in the USB to our computer, to the UART, and all the pin headers are connected. Now let's turn it on. Now it's on, so it's ready to load or flash the Linknode R4. So open the ESPEasy dist underscore dist and then run this ESPEasy flasher. Okay, so let's open the ESPEasy flasher. Then once you open it, it will automatically detect the COM port of the USB UART, and then you need to select the firmware or the bin file, which is the one that we just copied from the bin folder, which is this one here, 4m1m.bin. And you have option here to do a post flash action. Once you tick that one, and then you put in the unit name, number, and then the password, the admin, also the Wi-Fi SSID and the Wi-Fi password. And then once it's finished the flashing, it will automatically configure with this post flash action that you just defined. But we're not gonna do that. All I need to do is just click the flash to flash the Linknode R4 straight away. Now let's flash this one. So just click the flash ESPEasy firmware or FW, and it will tell you straight away the approximate number of seconds to flash this Linknode R4. And if you look at the device itself, the Linknode R4, you can see that there's a light activity on the module, and also with the UART, means that something is going on. So 111 seconds is almost 2 minutes. 2 minutes is 120 seconds. So we'll just wait. Okay, so that's done. As you can see, there's a text here, it says done. You may disconnect the unit if you want. Next one is you just need to close this one. And then on your device, you can turn off the Linknode R4. Yeah, that's off. And then you can disconnect the cables. And also, guys, as mentioned before, that this one here, once you finish the flashing, you need to move this to this one here, the 3.3 volts. So let's do that now. Like that. So it means that we are going to boot the device to its flash, and then you can now turn on the Linknode R4 again, and we can start the programming or connecting it to the Wi-Fi. Okay, so let's connect the Linknode R4 to our Wi-Fi network. You can use mobile phone or laptop or computer with Wi-Fi interface on it. In our case, I'll be using iPhone. So to do that, let's go to our Wi-Fi network settings and look for ESPEasy SSID and click that, and then put in the password, which is config ESP. Let's type that in, and once you do that, click join. There you go. Okay, so once you done that, it will open automatically a web GUI, and from there you can connect to your wireless network. At the moment, I cannot see my Wi-Fi network here, so I need to click the rescan, and there you go. So it is now showing my Wi-Fi network. So I'm gonna select Tiger, and then put in my Wi-Fi password. So once everything is all good, click connect, and Wi-Fi setup wizard will start, and with a timer on it, it's now 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, 0. Now it says warning, connected via AP. So it is now connected. As you can see, I have IP addresses there. So the one we are looking for is the IP address, which is 192.168.88.52. You can then go to your computer and open your browser and type in that IP address, and that should open the GUI. Let's do that. Okay, I got a browser open here. So let's type in the IP address of the Linknode R4, which is 192.168.88.52. And there you go. By the way, guys, you have to make sure that your computer or laptop should be in the same network with your Linknode R4, so that you can communicate with your Linknode R4. And that's it, guys. As you can see, it is now flashed with the ESPEasy binary file that we have selected. So if you have any question, guys, please write in the comment below, and I will try my best to answer your question. And please don't forget to like and subscribe. We'll see you soon in my next video. Thanks for watching.